my dearest.
Wilford Reynolds, a lawyer and mother of six, Agnes Borsig, and a mailman, Cliff Clavin. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
Thank you, Johnny. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, everyone, and welcome to a very special edition of Jeopardy.
Thank you, Alex.
You're welcome, Cliff. This is the very first time we have taken our program out on location, and what better
Cliff,
place
you
to
makeup?
Start than in the historic
Well,
rich
this is
city
a special day for
Boston, Massachusetts. We have three new contestants with us today, one of them at least very eager to show how bright he is. So let's get right to it. Players, good luck. We're now going to play the first round of Jeopardy. And here are the categories for you. Civil servants. Stamps from around the world. Mothers and sons. Beer, bar trivia, and finally, celibacy. If you want to come across backstage.
This has got to be Mr. Clavin's dream board.
Sure, he's home free, as long as he doesn't get too cocky.
Cliff, could I get you to pick a category and an amount?
Why don't you go ahead and pick anyone you want? I mean, I am feeling lucky today. Whoa!
Uh-oh.
Okay, we're back in 30 seconds.
Can you believe it? Mr. Clavin's going into Final Jeopardy with $22,000.
Yeah, and I'm really depressed, too.
Why?
Well, I know he's going to blow it before I have a chance to hit him up for a loan.
Come on, he's way ahead. There's no way he can lose.
Well, you got to have faith, Woody.
Three, two...
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Our Final Jeopardy category is movies. In a moment, contestants, I'll give you the clue. You'll then have 30 seconds to write down your question. Here we go. Our Final Jeopardy answer is... Archibald Leach, Bernard Schwartz, and Lucille LeSueur. Good luck, players. Cliff, you're not looking over there to see what Agnes is writing down, are you?
No, Alex, I wouldn't try anything sleazy like that. I was just admiring the cut of her jacket. Very shapely for a mother of six, if I might say. There you are.
You've got about 5 seconds to go.
All right, all right.
Well, where's the makeup guy? Mr. Clavin's starting to look a little pasty.
You would, too, if you bet everything you had and didn't know the answer.
What makes you think he didn't know the answer?
Well, a lot of people wouldn't have noticed, Woody, but there's a little stream of blood trickling down his chin where he's bitten through his lower lip.
Good try. Agnes, what did you put down? Who are Tony Curtis, Cary Grant, and Lucille Ball? You're still very close, but you're incorrect, unfortunately, and that means it's going to cost you $2,900. That takes you down to $400. And it takes us to Cliff. Cliff, good news for you. Both of your opponents came up with incorrect responses, and what that means is that even if you're wrong, as long as you didn't do anything foolish like wager everything, you're a cinch winner.
Well, then we don't have to see my answer, do we there, Alex? Listen, we'll see you at the Tournament of Champions.
Cliff, we're running out of time, and we are going to have to take a look at your response. You wrote down, who are three people who have never been in my kitchen? No, I'm sorry, that too is wrong. The correct response is, what were the real names of Cary Grant, Tony Curtis, and Joan Crawford?
Be that as it may, Alex, those people have never been in my kitchen.
Cliff, it's all right. You don't have to worry. Unless you risk more than $21,600, you will be the new Jeopardy champion. So let's take a look and see what your wager was. You bet 22,000 big ones. It takes you down to zero. You bet it all. Cliff, why would you do something like that?
Because I knew that those people had never been in my kitchen. You can ask them. Come on, Tony Curtis is still alive. Get him on the phone. Go ahead. I'll pay for the call.
This isn't going to work, Cliff. Sorry. Agnes, $400 is not a big total, but today it's enough to make you the new Jeopardy champion. So congratulations.
Oh, no, she's me. I'm your champion. I answered all those questions. You saw me, America. Write in and tell them. Your mail
Come on, Wood. If we sneak out right now, nobody will know we're with him.
If you call Tony, stop delivering your mail. Tony Curtis, if you're out there and you can hear me, call in and I'll split the pot with you.